to figure skating. There's Patrick Chan of Canada. Here are Brenda, Carol, and Kurt.
Okay, Scott, this is the final flight in the men's team competition, the short program portion of the event. We have some of the biggest names in men's figure skating right now in this flight, among them Patrick Chan. And of course, Nathan Chen, the American, the Quad King from Russia, Mikhail Koliada, and from Japan, Shoma Uno. And there we can see Patrick Chan. He will be first to skate out on this ice. Five competitors left to go. The leader at the moment from Italy is Matteo Rizzo. That score, almost 78 points. Again, it's the placement that counts, not really the
score.
You could feel the energy level ramp up in the building when these guys took to the ice. That warm up, wow.
Jumps were flying. Like floating with beautiful landings. Patrick was a little loose in the air on a couple of his jumps. So he'll want to snap that nice and tight in the air so that there's no ambiguity. Taking a look at it, I believe it'll be quad toe in the warm up. You can see a slight lean and his shoulders up. Everything just a tiny bit tense, but you know what? That's what it's called, a warm up. It's called a warm up, so.
And what Patrick does in the warm-up isn't indicative necessarily, good or bad, of how he skates in the actual competition. But there's so many question marks surrounding Patrick this season. Now, not to put too much pressure on Patrick, but many people feel that Canada's medal hopes in this team event rest with Patrick. And he said that the team event has been his focus leading up to the games.
One of the best movers across the ice in the sport's history. Right now, he just needs to trust himself. Lean, big lean. Quad toe, triple toe was planned. He obviously didn't get the second jump off. This is a triple Lutz, we'll probably put it in combination with only a double, but he got it done.
Last jump now, the triple axel, which is the one that actually traditionally has caused him more problems than the quad. He'll be hoping to get a good one out today. No, not to be.
Of the song coming back to haunt you, how quickly things can change. Wanting so desperately to reach back this week into some of his practice skates, looking every bit Patrick Chan.
Well, unfortunately for Canadian fans, not vintage Patrick today, but this has been a season of upheaval, of change.
Well, we were talking about building a rhythm over the season to help you peak towards the Olympics. And Patrick's season has just been so fractured that it must have been incredibly difficult for him to build momentum. He's changed coaches, a move that I think is all to the good, but very late in the game, and it's another change. It's something else to get used to. And it's a lot for a skater to deal with.
Well, one of the biggest things he had to deal with is after his break from competitive skating, he came back and the men's event was completely different,
yes.
Rewritten with a different set of rules, which included a quad lutz, a quad flip, a quad loop, intermixed with programs with five quads. And so the landscape was completely different, and he probably took a long time to look around as a competitor and say to himself, how do I fit in? And I think it was a lot, and very brave of him to come back. And I know he wanted to make a big dent and a splash in this event. And I feel for him right now tremendously, because I know his heart's pretty broken.
And we were saying how key his performances are to whether Canada can win that gold medal here in South Korea.
Well, he's opened the door now for Colliada to walk through. As we said, that was the big matchup, that, you know, if Patrick could be as close to him as possible, but
not close, he had to beat him.
Well, preferably,
yep.
Yes.
Yep. In this event, close doesn't count.
No.
Just seemed like he didn't quite, once you were in the air, he didn't quite believe in that fraction of a second. And it took the best, it got the best of him.
So that score of 81.66 is about 13 points lower than his season's best short program score.
And once again, it's that second mark, the transitions, performance, interpretation, skating skills.
If it was a skating skills competition, he would win, no problem.
Every time.
So he sits in first place for the moment.
Our next skater represents Israel. Alexei
Bichenko made history at the last games as the very first Israeli man to compete in singles skating. And here he's making history once again as Israel qualifies a team for the first time ever. Now, he is a native Ukrainian, as a lot of Israeli skaters have been in the past, but the opportunity to compete on the world stage was offered by Israel, and he walked through that door. And what a difference he has made to what Israel has been able to accomplish in figure skating.
Well, speaking of open doors, there's actually one available to him now. A great skate from him would be a higher score than what Patrick just put up. And he's off to a good start. Capable of scoring in the short program over 81, he now becomes a problem on Patrick's side. Quad toe clean.
No second look at that one required.
I misinterpreted his feline abilities. That lutz didn't look good in the air, but he stepped out of it and will actually get positive grade of execution. His teammates going crazy, and they should.
But you know, this is his seventh event this season. He's had time to figure out what works, what doesn't, do it under pressure, and he's got that look of confidence about him that says, I can do this program, no problem.
Welcome to the highlight of your career so far.
Well, he is a big reason why the Israelis have a team here in Pyeongchang. And Alexei Bitchenko should move into first place with that performance.
In the last few years of the World Championships, he's been 15th, 17th, 13th, and then 10th. But that, wow.
It was so solid.
That was
so solid.
That was boom, a top boom, level boom. Skate.
Yeah, absolutely.
Nicely packaged too, with a piece of music that seemed to suit him, bring out his personality. Didn't rely on a lot of beautiful long lines, no balletic influence there. I'm just gonna skate, I'm gonna have fun, I'm gonna hit my musical highlights, and I'm gonna land a lot of tough jumps and make them look easy.
And when you do that, it's much easier to sell the program because you're having fun. It's like, I'm yeah. doing my thing. Here I go. Coach Galit Scheidt, former ice dancer. Just had to get that one in there, Kurt, sorry.
So I wouldn't say he's a natural jumper. I would say that he does create the jumps. He doesn't just use the momentum, and that timing isn't necessarily perfect, and his position in the air is a little bit loose, and none of those things seemed to matter today. He was right over those back outside edges on his landings. Oh, here's a great slow-mo look at what he's doing. Right over top the right side of his body, right where he needs to be.
He almost has time to point his toe as he lands to show, look at my clean landing.
Reaching for the ice on your way down with your ankle and having the toe touch first. See, that one, it wasn't quite as much.
Nope.
But, you know, if you're going to land, I think you should land your jumps like your feet are cold. You know, when you jump and your feet are cold, you land as soft as you can. That's how you should land your jumps.
Party time on the Israeli bench.
That's right.
So if he even comes close to his season's best personal best scores, he will move into first place here.
He should with that skate.
Patrick Chan's score was 81.66.
This long wait blows out my theory of when you do things wrong, you need extra time for the judges to look at it.
Okay. We're waiting on the ice.
Here we go.
Is Nathan Chen.
Look at Alexei's face. He's so excited.
Wow. So a season's best score for him. So we have a new leader here. Bitchenko with the lead, Patrick Chan of Canada in second place.
The skating world has been waiting for this moment for the last 3 years. Superstar.
Absolute. Absolutely. One might even say the quad god.
The odds makers think that this man has the best chance of winning gold in men's singles. They also see Nathan Chen as a key skater in the Americans' attempt to win a medal again in the team competition. And Nathan has not put a foot wrong this season. He's won every big event that he's entered.
But that's this season. He has not very much international experience, but he seems on this year. Having all his quads, his health, his skates all seem to be firing at the right time, and he's on the ice at the Olympics. Quad flip, a little trouble, so only a double toe afterwards. Let everybody know at home that that is not a normal quad. That quad flip is worth much more than a quad toe or a quad sow. That change foot camel spin put there perfectly to move him down the program over the second half, into the second half of the program, so every jump now gets a 10% bonus. No. Misfire, only a double. Huge, unexpected mistake. So he did not mentally recover from doing a double toe, which will not even be counted as an element, and then falls on a triple axel. This is why you come to the rink to watch. You don't know what's going to happen.
Themselves in a bit of a hole. The two-time U.S. champion misfiring in his Olympic debut.
I'm sure he's in shock.
Well, he's looked a little off in practices. We've seen him actually do on practice this week what he did here today. And, you know, like you said, sometimes it's just a virus. If that starts to get in your head, oh, I missed something.
But where? Not in the warm-up.
No,
he was right
he
on
was
in
great.
The warm-up. He hit that beautiful quad flip off the top, and I guess he just torqued it around the corner a little too much, which I've done in competition. And you go too far around. I'll have to take a look at it in slow-mo. And that quad, he just couldn't rotate it. He needed to do at least a triple, but he only did two revolutions. This is the flip, four revolutions. Look how high he is. And there's a little chattering of the blade. He was hoping for a triple toe after that, but he only got a double, and maybe that is where he started to second guess himself. So we did not get a great look at the choreography by Shailene Bourne, world ice dance champion and Canadian. Because he just
outside the circle on that triple axel. You can see he had
kind
a lean.
Of the same mistake everyone's making on the axel today. Except Alexei Yuchenko.
Well, we were thinking that the Americans were gunning for that bronze medal position. This is obviously going to hurt. We'll see how much damage is done when we see the scores, or maybe more importantly, the placement. Mm-hmm.
It's all about the placement. The scores just give us a placement today. So Alexi, looking good. We've got Mikhail on the ice thinking, I've got a door open here.
Oh, yeah.
So that is his 25 points below his season's best score of 104.
And more importantly for Team Canada, below Patrick's score.
Well, you take the great risks, and sometimes they just don't pay off.
Next to skate, the Olympic athlete from Russia, Mikhail Poliada.
But for Nathan Chen, a quad toe is not a great risk.
Unless you're thinking about something else.
It has been a very strong season for this man, the 22-year-old. He's finished in the top three at all of the major events, including the Grand Prix final and Europeans. He does, though, have a reputation of being a bit of an inconsistent skater because his big jumps do not always have a high success rate.
Right off the bat as he comes down to do a quad lutz.
We talked
kind of a day.
Well, we talked about strategy, and I don't understand this one. Short program.
Skate
Get
clean.
Points from every element. And why are you trying a quad lutz? This one makes sense. Quad toe. That was supposed to be in combination, and so we call it jump math. Well, he's only got one other option, and he can't do it on the axle. He just lost his combination.
He just lost his option, yep.
Up, he did a triple axel that took our breath away. That jump right there is why I don't have an Olympic medal. I singled my jump.
Well, in today's rules, he gets no points for that at all because you're not allowed to do a single axel. So he's really basically left all of his jumping points on the table.
Building is hushed. Uno backstage. Is somebody telling him what's going on out here? Or is he just gonna come out here and do his job?
The Canadian team was just handed a huge gift by Mikhail Poliada.
Second time we've seen an element completely stripped away from a skater, and at the worst time at the Olympic Games, and that just doesn't happen very often, and it's happened to Nathan Chen and now to Mikhail. He's in shock.
I think the whole building's in shock. Nobody really knows what to say or think. And again, as you say, he took a huge risk with the quad lats, not really needing to today.
Huge.
So why wouldn't he have changed it at the last second? Is it just too much to process and to...
Especially with what Patrick did already. Mm-hmm. So knowing that, as a team leader, why do you not walk up to him and go, guy, you don't need the quad lats today. You just need to skate clean. Canada has left the door open, but maybe he just wasn't feeling good with... I don't know. I just think it was bad strategy. Here's the look at it. Didn't reach very far back. Boy, he gets high in the air, though.
So high, though, yeah.
Just came down too low, and the momentum took over.
Oh, I know how you feel. That's the coach's face for you.
Quad toe.
Perfectly clean.
So you can see his body position as he lands. The shoulders are up, the arms are up, way up near the chest line, and that makes you more like, you're higher. Your balance is too high.
Your
body is obviously tense, and then your mind goes to work, and you don't remember how to do a jump. You don't remember.
It's like gymnasts. Why do they stick the landing with the arms low and out in front? Because that's the most solid position to land in.
This has been such a tremendous season for him. Winning the Cup of China and then finishing on the podium at the Grand Prix final, also on the podium at Europeans. A lot of people thought that some of the inconsistency in his skating had evaporated.
There's another, sorry, Brenda.
No, just resurfacing at obviously the wrong time.
I just realized that three of the top competitors in the men's event now have to carry this memory with them into the singles event later on in the games. Mind games. They're not the Olympic games, they're the mind games.
74.36. His season's best score is 103 points. We have seen some disappointing skating so far from these men in the team competition.
And Patrick Chan is dodging bullets today.
The skate gods are smiling on us.
Here's our final competitor in this men's team short program competition. Shoma Uno. And he comes here hoping to emerge out of the shadow of world and Olympic champion Yuzuru Hanyu. He certainly has a chance to do so in this team competition. Shoma is Japan's go-to man now that injuries have forced Yuzuru to take a pass on the team competition. He's focusing on the men's single event, which will take place a little bit later in the Olympic menu.
If he can be the skater that carries that beautiful warm-up, that 5-minute warm-up before the skate into his skate, he will be the star tonight. Quad flip, same as Nathan Chen did.
No!
By Vivaldi, one of the most artistic, edgy, committed skaters to his music I've ever seen. Pushed past the halfway point in this program, 10% bonus for every jump after this. He has to combo the next jump. He's planning a quad toe, triple toe.
just a sigh of relief that he did such a beautiful job on that jump.
One blemish for Shoma Uno, but the best skate that we have seen so far in this men's team competition.
We had three clean skates out of 10.
Two, huh?
Not enough.
Not enough, yeah. Korean boy skated clean, and so did the Israeli gentleman.
And
I don't did anybody else.
Pachenko.
That's it. That's Israel. Pachenko and Korea had the two clean skates.
That's it.
That's it. That's almost so not what we expected from this event.
Triple flip coming down under rotated. The second foot, we call the free foot, the toe pick hits the ice. You're supposed to land on only one foot. You can see it come down, bam, both will hit. He was under rotated and flip out. We call it a step out, flipped out. Now, because it's a flip, there's so many points awarded that difficult jump that he'll still get anywhere from 8 to 9 points for the effort there. So that's why it's important to rotate with the judging system. Definitely you have to rotate all those jumps.
And then after that, he really seemed to pull himself together and skated absolutely superbly for the rest of the program. The other two jumps, just gorgeous. And his flow and speed across the ice are just exquisite. The knee action, the bend, the use of the ankles. He just is really a skater's skater, isn't he?
That's well put, yeah. And I just feel that you're watching an athlete and artist blended so well in Shoma.
Well, here's the good news from a Canadian perspective. Likely that Patrick Chan is going to finish in third place and Koliada is going to be way down in eighth. So that would give the Canadians
eight points
and Koliada and the Olympic athletes from Russia just 3 points. Let's see what happens here with the scores for Shoma Uno. So 103 points.
Breaking the 100.
Wow.
That's awesome.
So he will finish in first place. So the Japanese will pick up those valuable 10 points from this competition. But again, the Canadians do not fare too badly here. They pick up 8 points with Patrick's third place finish, and the Russians way down in eighth place and only have 3 points. So a big 5-point spread between Canada and the Olympic athletes from Russia. So the Canadians are going to be happy with how this first phase, first of eight, ended here. These are the 23rd Olympic Winter Games from Pyeongchang.